That's, I mean, it's certainly possible, but you know, I think you're right. You know, in the infancy, you know, there are a lot of issues like this, but I think we have gotten past some of them. Okay. Yeah, let me get there.
Has your organization done any performance measurement in the cases where you have network connections dropping a small percentage of packets and seeing how that affects the performance of the system?
Yeah, we have used, you know, different networks and all that, but you know, I can't, you know, I'm not aware of exactly what the results of that, and you know, I'm a little bit removed from that. But you know, if you're interested, we can, you know, I can check and get back to you. Yeah.
Some of the other systems I've heard, they don't actually replicate those, they replicate key sets. Is that what this system does?
Oh, yeah, yeah. It only replicates keys. You know, yeah.
Well, no, my point is that if you remember those 1, 2, 3, 4, one is not replicated.
Oh, no. You're not replicating the whole thing, because then you're in trouble, right?
Yeah.
Because what happens is, you know, if these two go, then you're pretty much dead in the water, right? Whereas at least if you replicate, you know, differently, there is a chance that some of the keys can be served for at least some time, right? So only the key sets you replicate, not the entire
That's not big. But I'm glad there are a lot of questions here. You know, I'm kind of in a quandary. I don't know what to do with the t-shirts. You know, there's a lot of questions. So maybe I'll randomly pick names from there. Okay, so how do I connect? Very, very simple. You know, once you have the jar files, I provide the link list of the URI. I don't really need to provide all the nodes participating in the cluster. I need to provide one. Okay, the question immediately comes up, what happens if that particular node I'm connecting to goes down? Doesn't matter, okay? It keeps a connection to all the different nodes which are participating in the cluster, right? And then what happens is, I add the list to the URIs. I specify the URIs. I specify the bucket I want to connect to. I specify the password and number. Okay? So it's as simple as that. That kind of makes sense? Okay? Yeah.
Well, you wouldn't need a list of URIs, but then we try to have real production system, because if the server goes down, you're right, you're fine, you've already connected. But if you haven't connected, then as soon as you try to come in, you will fail, right? So you must, presumably, I use a load balancer, or you have to go through the list.
Right, a lot of customers, what they do is they kind of generate this programmatically, and you know, they have a configuration file, they load up the configuration, and go through the list. You know, there are ways of getting around it. But you know, for simple development, for simple prototyping, I think this is good enough. Okay. Here it shows